See, Hawaba, Shabi, Hawasha, double honors to the apostles and elders, the great millstone. Shalom to the octave and four corners of the earth, the 144,000, the one third, the house of David, the elect. We are the Israelites. We are the descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. We've been commanded by our Lord, whom the world calls Jesus Christ, whose true name is Yahweh Shai, to come out here and gather the Lord's sheep of the house of Israel. All right, so the brother's going to read the scripture. It's the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 6, verse 4.
This is Deuteronomy, chapter 6, verse 4. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord.
That's right, the one Lord of the Bible is who we're professing. Because the one Lord is not Allah, his name is not God. God is an Indo-European word. In Hebrew is Yahweh, okay? We are the sons of Yahweh. And by the grace and mercy of the Lord, we're out here preaching his word, teaching his word, okay? And that word, that good word is for the Israelites. You black Americans, you're the tribe of Judah. You Puerto Ricans are the tribe of Ephraim, okay? And you Mexicans are the tribe of Issachar. All down this chart, this is what we're looking for. The lost sheep of the house of Israel. You can read on, brother. Verse 5.
And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thine heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy might. And these words which I commend thee this day shall be in thine heart.
That's
right. And thou shalt teach them diligently unto thy children, and shalt talk of them which thou sittest in thine, when thou sittest in thine house, and when thou walkest by the way, and when thou liest down, and when thou risest up.
That's right.
And thou shalt bind them for a sign upon thine hand, and they shall be as frontlets between thine eyes, and thou shalt write them upon the posts of thy house and on thy gates.
That's good.
And it shall be when the Lord thy God shall have brought thee into the land which he swore unto thy fathers, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob, and to give thee great and goodly cities which thou buildest not, and houses full of all good things which thou fillest not, and well digged which thou diggest not, and vineyards and olive trees, and
That's good.
Thou blendest not. When thou shalt have eaten and be full, then beware lest thou forget the Lord which brought thee forth out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage. Thou shalt fear the Lord thy God and serve him, and shalt swear by his name. Ye shall not go after other gods.
That's it. So the point is, the Lord our power, the word is one Lord. So we're gonna talk of the words of the Lord by the way. We're by the way right now. In our house, by the way, and to our children, and to our brothers, our sisters, those who were here, and those who will forbear, is all up to the Lord, right? So let me get 1 Samuel 2 and 3, brother. The book of 1 Samuel, chapter 2, verse 3. This, the Bible is the book of the Israelites, okay? It's not the book of the Chinese or the Europeans. This book was written in the so-called Middle East, all right? So it has nothing to do with Europe, Japan, China, South Pacific, nothing to do with America. This is the prophets all from the land of Israel, okay? And they were in captivity in different lands. So you got 1 Samuel 2 and 3?
This is
1
Samuel chapter...
I don't know what it is.
Yeah, 1 Samuel
2:3.
This is 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 3.
Read on.
Talk no more so exceedingly proudly. Let not arrogancy come out of your mouth. For the Lord is a God of knowledge, and by him actions are weighed.
That's right. So the God we're professing is a God of knowledge, right? So we're speaking knowledge out here, the knowledge of God. We're not speaking the so-called philosophy of the Catholic Church or the Protestants or Islam. We're not Muslim, we're Israelites, okay? Hebrew Israelites, okay? We got Hebrew names, and our culture and our heritage goes back to the Hebrews, specifically the family of Israel. All right, so give me Exodus 12 and 2. The God of knowledge. The God of knowledge is the God of the Bible, okay? That's the only God of the universe, okay? Not Hinduism gods. Exodus 12 and 2. So there's no gods. The other gods are idols, okay? We worship by the mercy and grace the true God of heaven and earth, which is Yahweh. And his son's name is Yahweh Shai, okay? 12 and 2.
This is Exodus chapter 12, verse 2. This month shall be unto you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year to you.
That's right. This is the beginning of the year, okay? January was the beginning of the year. The beginning of the year started 3 weeks ago. Because we worship the God of knowledge, which is Yahweh. You people don't know the true God. That's why on January 1st, you would say it's the beginning of the year. The true beginning of the year was 3 weeks ago. A bit. Let me get a... To prove that, let me get a... Exodus 13 and 4. It said, this month should be the beginning of months unto you. We know that's in March, April, which is the springtime.
This is Exodus chapter 13, verse 4. This day give me out in the month of Abib.
Read it again.
Exodus chapter 13, verse 4. This day give me out in the month of Abib.
Abib.
So Abib.
The true beginning of the year is not January, it's Abib. According to the Bible, people don't want to hear the Bible. They just want to go by the traditions of man, okay? Well, January 1st was created by, the worshiping or the commemoration of keeping the first day of January was made by Pope Gregory in the 16th century. From the 1580s, Pope Gregory changed the beginning of the year from March, April to January 1st at midnight. According to the Bible, the beginning of a day is at evening, okay? Not at 12 midnight. That 12 midnight is the witching hour, okay? So that's off. That's completely off. So we know what we're talking about because we worship the God of knowledge, which is Yahweh, okay? And his son's name is Yahweh Shai. So this month, we came out in the month of Abib, all right? Passover just ended. Passover is the true high holy day of the Lord's people, okay? Not Easter. Easter is a pagan holiday, okay? It has nothing to do with the truth of the Bible. Easter goes back to an ancient goddess, okay? Doesn't go back to the Lord of heaven and earth. It goes back to Babylon. All right, so we're Israelites. And this is modern day Babylon, and we're condemning this land for setting up these holidays and having our people worship those days, all right? So we're gonna read on. Let's go to Luke chapter 2. We're gonna talk about our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai. Black man, okay? Because you black Americans, you're the tribe of Judah. And Jesus Christ, his name is Yahweh Shai. He came out of your tribe, the tribe of Judah. All right? I'm from the tribe of Ephraim. This brother's from the tribe of Levi, okay? And we are the Israelites, okay?
Nice.
Yeah, let's go to Luke 2 and 1 for now.
This is the book of St. Luke chapter 2 verse 1. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed.
Right there. So Caesar was an Edomite, a so-called white man, a European, all right? We're the Israelites, and our forefathers were in captivity to a people called the Romans, okay? The Romans are not the Lord's people, all right? Caesar Augustus was an Edomite, all right? Edom means red. The red people are the so-called Europeans. The red people are not the Native Americans. They're brown-skinned people, right? So you try to stigmatize our people, saying they're redskin or red Indians. Now, the Native Americans, the tribe of Reuben and Gad, the North American Indians and the Seminole Indians are brown-skinned people. The Lord's people are brown, different shades of brown. So back then in the Roman Empire, Caesar Augustus taxed the people, right? Well, what's going on right now? We're in tax season. March, April is the tax season. So there's nothing due under the sun, all right? In the Roman Empire, they were taxing our people and the whole world, or the whole known world, which Rome, they ruled over the known world, and America rules over North, Central, South America, the Caribbean, all right? But the point is that this is taxing season, all right? So we know this is the springtime. Mm. Tax season in the Roman Empire was in the springtime, and so it is in this time, in the modern Roman Empire, taxing season. So read the second verse, huh?
This is Luke chapter 2, verse 2. And this taxing was first made in when Cyrenius was governor of Syria.
Yeah, that's another Edomite, okay? So we know the Edomites were taxing people, right? And this is happening right now. And this, everybody knows it's tax season. So we know that this is the springtime. When you read history like we do, we're historians, okay? We deal with the knowledge, wisdom, understanding of the Bible. We know that taxing season in the Roman Empire is the spring. So the topic is, what is the beginning of the year? And what is the true birthday of Yahweh Shai, Jesus Christ? It's the springtime, not in the winter, all right? We're gonna prove that in the sky, but
yeah, just to add to what you're saying, that's to prove that the Edomites and the Romans is the same people,
because that's right.
In the ancient times, when the Romans used to have you pay taxes, you pay tribute, but now in the modern day time, Esau got it to where you gotta pay tribute on the money that you make, on your income money, plus you gotta pay tribute on the on the property that you live in.
That's right.
You gotta pay tribute on everything that you buy. So that goes to show you that the Romans and the Edomites is the same people, the wicked that the Bible speak of.
Done.
I mean, the so-called white people, the Edomites.
Yep.
Good point, bro. That's a good point. Read, what you got, the third verse?
Yeah. This is Luke chapter 2, verse 3. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city.
That's right.
And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house of the lineage of Judah, of David.
That's right. So we're talking about Israelites, Salaka. We're talking about Israelites. This is not a book for everybody. That just named like what three towns in the land of Israel. We're not talking about people from China or Africa. We are the Israelites, all right? So this is that vibration, that energy, and that spirit has to be continually thrown out there, you know, into the atmosphere, into the winds.
Time.
Because Joseph was from the house of David, all right? You don't know these words because you think these are people from the Bible. It was just everybody could be represented by these people, but these people are specific people. Judites, all right? Israelites. What you got, brother?
This is Joel, the book of Joel, chapter 2, verse 27. And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, and that I am the Lord your God, and none else, and my people shall never be ashamed.
That's right. So we're not ashamed, because this is our book. That's a beautiful thing. We're not ashamed, and the Lord loves our people, but he's angry with our people. So a lot of our people is going to suffer in the coming martial law. The economic collapse of this country is going to bring martial law. It's going to bring race riots. It's going to bring famine. It's going to bring a new system in called the RFID chip implant system, which is going to be the mark of the beast.
Damn.
All right? It's going to bring troops on the streets, soldiers. And it's going to ultimately bring nuclear war to this world, all right? So we're calling our people to return back to your true nationality. That's what we're reading in the book of Luke, the story of the birth of the Lord. The Lord is a black man, all right? So-called black. Dark skin, dark brown skin. So go to Luke chapter 2, verse what, 3, 4?
4, yeah. This is the book of Luke chapter 2, verse 4. And Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth unto Judea, unto the city of David,
that's
which
right.
is called Bethlehem.
That's right.
To be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child.
Right, so being great with child, that's very important. Being great with child, meaning she was in her late stages of a pregnancy, okay? Mm-hmm. So we know, one, that it was tax season, you know, that's the springtime. And we know that Mary, all right, the mother of the Lord, Jesus Christ, is a black man, Yahweh Shai.
She was a black woman.
Yeah, she was a black woman herself. She was from the tribe of Levi, all right, Mary. Not that white picture you see, that's from the Renaissance, from Italy, all right?
Done.
Mary was a black woman, her son and Joseph, the father, they were all a black family.
That's
they
right.
went to go get taxed, all right, because the Romans were in control of our homeland, the land of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
So they went to get taxed. It was springtime. She was great in pregnancy, all right? So we know she was ready to give birth during that time. So that proves, that's one clue that the Lord was born in the springtime. So read on, brother.
But
what you got?
Just to add to what you were saying, what you just said,
yeah.
Just to prove that Mary was a so-called black woman, because so-called black people, when you two black people have a so-called black child, it's not going, unless it's a deformity, he's not gonna be a white child. See what I'm saying? So if Mary was a so-called white woman, why would she run to Egypt to hide from the Romans?
That's right. That's a good point.
She would get cancer. She would just drop dead with Joseph.
Yeah, that was during the beginning of her pregnancy.
Yeah.
They went to Egypt. That's right. That's a good point.
Them Egyptians. We all know Egyptians was dark skinned. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
And we also know Jeremiah, the book of Jeremiah, chapter 14, verse 2, says the tribe of Judah is black, all right?
Mm.
So the Lord left that spirit in that scripture to prove, amongst other scriptures and history and archaeology, that the real Jews are black. That's what we're telling the people out here. It's a beautiful thing that the Lord has blessed us once again. All praise is due to Yahweh Ba'ashan, Yahweh Shah, that he has us out here trying to gather the lost sheep of the house of Israel, the elect, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So we're in the book of Luke. This is the lesson for today, the Lord's birth, okay? Not in the winter time, but in the springtime. What you got, brother?
This is Luke chapter 2, verse 6. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered.
That's right, so I finished saying that. It came to pass that she was the days to be delivered.
Mm-hmm.
So she was actually going to give birth during tax season. So these people don't know what the hell they're talking about out here, bro. I got to put it like that for the last Yeah, for actually thousands of years, people have taught that the Lord was born in the wintertime, December 25th. That's a lie. That goes to the ancient Babylonian religion, mystery religion of Nimrod, Semiramis, which is Ashtoreth, and Tammuz. You don't know those names because you don't study the Bible, but they're in the Bible, and they're in ancient history. So they try to put that story on the Lord's birth, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Try to mix that up. That happened in Europe. We know, we're reading and proving that the Lord was born in the springtime, all right? So, you got a piece of
that? Yeah. Oh, yeah, I got a piece of it on the destruction of Babylon. It talks about the second Ezra, it talks about as a woman is child.
Nah, drop it.
Verse 7. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger.
That's right, the firstborn son of Mary and Joseph was the Lord. His true name in Hebrew, the ancient pure language, is Yahweh Shai. We're going to keep throwing that name out there, you know, exalting that name rather, okay? We're going to exalt Yahweh Shai because Jesus Christ is a translation of the ancient Hebrew, but we got to return back to the true name, all right? That's the name that all people are going to bow down to in this earth, okay?
God.
All of you spirits out here is going to bow down to Yahweh Shai, right? Because that's the will of Yahweh. That's the will of the Father, okay? We're teaching the Bible as they ought to be taught, not how the Catholic Church, they're corrupt. That's obvious. You know, they're pedophiles, all right? They have blood on their hands for what they did to the Native Americans, the Aztecs, the Mayas, the Taínos. They had a hand in the slave trade. So you people are done and you're finished, all right? So what you got?
It says verse 8, and there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night.
All right, so wait a minute. This was the winter time. Why is a shepherd at night time? At night, this is significant. Why? Because they say that Jesus Christ, all right, his true name is Yahweh Shai, was born in the winter. But right now, we're just reading the circumstances and the events surrounding the birth of the Lord. It says there were shepherds keeping the flock by night. So there's no way this is the winter time because shepherds don't do that. Shepherds don't hold their sheep, you know, or their flock at nighttime. Right. That'll be torture, you know. These shepherds were Israelites, okay? So we know that this is all leading up to the conclusion and the reality that this is taking place during the springtime, right? So read on, brother.
This is verse 9. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone right about them, and they were so afraid. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I will bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Mashiach the Lord. This shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
Good stuff right there. So the baby, Yahweh Shai, whom the world calls Jesus Christ, a black man. Jesus Christ is a black man. He is not an Italian. He is not a Roman, all right? He was a black man with woolly hair, all right? So you can understand. So you can go home and have nightmares, all right? But that Savior is coming back for a specific number of his people, the Israelites. So when he was born, he was wrapped in swaddling clothes. So there's no way in a manger, in the middle of the night, you would put a baby in a manger in a farmhouse. That's not reality. So you actually blaspheme the birth of the Lord. Say he was born amongst farm animals in a barn in the middle of the night. That's blasphemy, right? You changed the truth of the Bible and made it a lie. Who did that? The Catholic Church. You Protestants, all right? So the Israelites are back, and we're gonna, by the grace and mercy that the Lord has put elders and apostles over us to teach us these things, and we're gonna repeat these things, all right? Because it's the truth. So
this is Luke chapter 2, verse 41. And now his parents went to Jerusalem every year at the feast of the Passover.
All right, so this is significant. Every year that the parents went every year at the feast of the Passover. So this is a tradition, all right? So this is still happening when? The Passover is when? It's in the springtime. So tax season was in springtime. The shepherds keeping field by night. That's another clue of springtime. Now it's telling you many years later that they went every year at the feast of the Passover. All right? So that's the springtime. Mm-hmm. So we know the Lord was born in the springtime. Mm-hmm. This is clear. Thank be to Yahweh Shem, Yahweh Shah. They have cleared this madness up, all right? Not no damn winter, all right? So what we got?
Verse 42. And when he was 12 years old, they went up to Jerusalem after the custom of the feast.
Every year, the custom of the feast of Passover. We just kept Passover by the grace and mercy of Yahweh Basham, Yahweh Shai, right? Here in Babylon, the great, we praise the last Passover and the Lord takes us out of this hell, this condition of hell, right? Because hell is not a condition underneath the ground. The hell is a condition above the ground. It's society in Manhattan, Brooklyn, Bronx, Queens, Staten Island, the projects, the reservations, of Mexico, Brazil, that's hell, all right? Where the white, everywhere the white man is at, the Europeans, that's hell, okay? That conditions on earth is where you see heaven and hell. So, what you got, brother?
Verse 43, and when they had fulfilled their days, as they returned, the child, Yahusha, tarried behind in Jerusalem, and Joseph and his mother knew none of it.
Read on. Yeah, so the Lord, he didn't go with his parents. So this is very important. Why didn't the Lord, at 12 years old, didn't accompany his parents when they were leaving the custom of the feast, they were leaving Jerusalem? He stood behind as a 12-year-old, actually he was a 12-year-old man, a young man. We're going to prove the reason why he stood behind and his response to his parents when they asked him, why did he tarry behind? So what you got, brother?
Verse 44. But they, supposing him to have been in the company,
that's right,
went a day's journey, and they sought him among their kinsfolk and acquaintance. And when they found him not, they turned back again to Jerusalem, seeking him.
That's right.
And it came to pass that after the 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the doctors, both hearing them and asking them questions.
That's right. That's right.
All that heard them were astonished at his understanding and answers. And they saw him, and they were amazed. And his mother said unto him, Son, why hast thou thus dealt with us? Behold, thy father and I have sought thee sorrowing. And he said unto them, How is it that ye sought me? Wist ye not that I must be about my father's business?
That's right. So the reason that he said that is because he became a man, all right? Mm. He, at 12 years old, in the Hebrew, the culture of, in our heritage as Israelites, at 12 years old is when you become a man, according to the Bible, okay? Mm-hmm. According to our culture and heritage. So the Lord, Yahweh Shai, at 12 years old, he said, Why are you looking for me, mother? Why are you looking for me, father? Don't you know I must be about my father's business? So a part of his ministry started when he was 12 years old, but we know at 30, it was official when he went to go teach his people. But he became a man at 12 years old. So that was around what time? That was around the Passover, springtime. We gave you 3 or 4 clues, all right? So there's no coincidence. A coincidence is with 2 or more things, you know what I'm saying? So it is true. It is actually true that the Lord was born in the springtime. It was sack season. Mary gave birth during that same season, which was spring. The shepherds were out by night, and the Lord turned 12 years old because it was every year they went up at the Feast of the Passover. And when he was 12 years old, read what it says when he was 12 years old. Yeah, read that, just read that.
Verse 42. And when he was 12 years old.
And when he was 12 years old, when it says, and when is a dispensation of time, right? It means at that time. When means at that time, he was 12 years old, meaning he turned 12 years old around the time of the Passover. So we just came out of the time of the Lord's birthday, all right? Which was the Passover, all right? That's the Israelite high holy day, all right? The true holidays are the holy days of the Bible, okay? Not Easter. So we're here to destroy the lies of Easter.